Welcome back to the Kingdom Hearts Legacy. After exploring the deep mindfuck that was the events of Recoded, we are now taking a trip down backwards. We are taking a trip backwards into the prequel of Kingdom Hearts 1. And you'll find out that big giant moon, that is Kingdom Hearts! We've seen that referenced a lot in the series. So yeah. And while this may not be a long stream, I can already tell you for one thing, I have not played this game in ages. At last I played it was on normal. Mainly easy because A, I was new to that game, and B, everything was different. Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep Final Mix. Now, this is the last game in Disc 1, mind you. This is the final game in Disc 1. Because once I complete this, all three stories on Proud with the true ending, we'll be moving on to the second disc. And yeah, We will be doing a Proud Mode. I'm not doing it on Critical. Vibration on. Let's begin. The torture begins. Oh, it's showing the opening again. I probably should skip it. Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep. Yep, it's showing the opening again. We already saw that. We already saw that, though. There's a reason why I skipped it. We already seen that intro cutscene.
Is just too small.
Who is that?
Mm-hmm.
There's Xehanort.
There, you see, an empty world, like a prison. I imagine you will be right at home.
Who's there?
Okay, this is all new to me. First time I've ever seen Ventus with no shirt. Shirtless Ventus confirmed. I'm a brand new heart.
But this is... Why are you in my heart?
The light brought me. I saw it shining in the distance.
My life, but my heart is fractured, and now the little I have left is slipping away.
Nothing else will slip away. And one day I didn't have time to read all that!
Thanks.
You'll be strong enough to win it back. That part already did. It's time to wake up now. All we need to do is...
Open the door.
Definitely. It's weird seeing Ventus without a shirt. It's just weird. Seeing Ventus with no shirt is weird. Again, it's been how many years since I played this version of the game? So yeah, there is no command actions. There is none of that. Okay, that is a little creepy, that mask there. and a lot of people thought, oh!
A meteor shower!
Oh, this is Roxas we're playing as! No, we're not playing as Roxas! Get that through your skull before I slap you one. That is not Roxas. That is Ventus, the one that was referenced in... Three coded.
I can't see much from here.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. I've got time to spare.
Oh, yeah, it's doing the tutorial. So this was the thing that Deb was referring to. Use command deck or L2 and R2. I'm gonna use the L2 and R2. Makes it a little bit easier for me.
You want a piece of me too?
Chest right there. Yep, Ventus. It's weird. I didn't even choose Ventus. And like Dev, I accidentally thought triangle was to open the box, but this is PSP controls that we're talking about here.
What am I messing around here for? I'm gonna miss the meteor shower.
So yeah, for those thinking, this is PS2 graphics? No, this is PSP graph. This is the PSP game, mind you. And now, what's gonna happen?
Sleepyhead. You know, you should have at least brought a blanket.
But did I dream that place up? It really felt like I'd been there before, looking up at the stars.
Except you've always lived here with us.
Yeah. I know. Hey, Aqua.
Hmm?
You ever wonder what stars are? Where light comes from?
Hmm. Well, they say...
that every star up there is another world.
Huh?
Oh. There's the Lingering Will himself.
Hard to believe there are so many worlds out there besides our own. The light is their hearts. And it's shining down on us like a million lanterns.
What? I don't get it.
In other words, they're just like you, Ben.
What does that mean?
You'll find out someday, I'm sure.
I want to know now.
You're too young to know now.
Quit treating me like a kid.
Hey, what are you laughing at?
I can't help it. You two would make the weirdest brothers.
Huh?
Huh?
So yeah, Birth by Sleep, final mix. I'm playing on Proud, there's no going back. All I know is that prepare for pain and misery because I get to choose the character. The character I start with
yeah.
First.
Tara, you and I have our Mark of Mastery exams tomorrow. I made us good luck charms.
Whoa.
Here.
I get one too?
Of course. One for each of us.
Yeah.
Somewhere out there, there's this tree with star-shaped fruit. And the fruit
so yeah, the order that I will be playing
so
in, I don't know if I'm going to be able to.
Shape like it. Nothing can ever drive you apart.
I don't know if I'm going to choose the character I play as.
Technically, I think you're supposed to make them with seashells, but I did the best with what I had.
Boy, sometimes you are such a girl.
Hey, what do you mean sometimes?
So this isn't a real good luck charm?
Well. That's yet to be seen. But I did work a little magic on it.
Really? What?
An unbreakable connection.
Wayfinder. The Wayfinder allows you to dimension link with friends and borrow their powers. You meet lots of characters throughout the story that you can de-link with.
Well, tomorrow's the exam. Anybody want to spar?
I can take you.
Oh, right. I get to play as Tara now. So, HP gauge on the what? Represent your health. And out of HP, and you'll be defeated. Oh yeah! And this is the character we will be playing as starting out with first. Then we'll do Ventus, and then finally we'll end it with Aqua. Makes sense, considering the fact... You can definitely tell this is PSP command.
So long.
So yeah, well, I think they did for this version. Command gauge fills up when your attacks hit enemies. If you go a few seconds without attack, it will start to drain. Once you fill the gauge up all the way, it'll... So what I think they did... is they literally... Using commands instead of your regular attacks to fill the command gauge may cause you to change command styles. So what I think they did, and I know I've been saying that a lot, is what they did was they merged PSP some of the PSP stuff, like the tutorial section where you play as Aqua and Ventus and Tara in each beginning of the story, into one section. Again, I don't know if it's the same way with the others. So what I guess they did is they changed some stuff up.
Well, that works fine if you're fighting one-on-one. But you need to know how to handle a crowd, too.
All right, now I'm playing Aqua. Use shot lock to command to hit your enemies at once. Hold R1 down. Shot lock attacks will require focus. Focus gauge will drain when you use them.
Okay, let's wrap this up.
Well, we're starting with Terra.
Gotcha!
Let's go.
It comes with experience.
I mean, we already know what the whole ordeal is.
Trust me. You guys are ready. We're gonna clean up the exam tomorrow.
I hope it's that easy.
It's like the Master said. Power is born within the heart. When the time is right, you just need to look inside yourself, and you'll find it there.
Power is born within the heart. During your travels, you can find new strength by playing the Command Board! In this game, you'll roll the dice and power up your commands as you make your way along the board. You can access command board, sequence, or on the world map. Well, we might as well start with Terra.
Oh, you don't want to lose track of stuff that's happened.
Oh. I'm back to playing Ventus again. And I'm back to playing as Ventus again. Oh. Get ready for this annoyance. Oh, you're gonna be... Because remember, this is a PSP game. Yeah, unlike the many other entries that we played, this one... Yeah, this one is so different. So yeah.
Hey, we're gonna head back.
Yeah, me too.
I'm gonna grab some food to eat real quick before I continue this. Because I already know it's not gonna be a long stream, but
tonight.
All right, let's continue. So, we're not going to be starting with Ventus' story. No, that is not correct. We will be doing this in the order that I see it. As how the order in the game sees it. Because the last time I played this ages and ages ago, I did Ventus first, and Aqua, and then Terra. Because now I'm curious if the order, if I do it in a different order, the order of the scenes will change.
That would be the last night we ever spent beneath the same stars.
There's Mickey! Yep. Definitely referencing that old, Sorcerer's Apprentice vibe.
Mickey, I cannot shake the feeling something terrible is about to transpire.
Yeah. Something bad's about to happen. Mainly Xehanort. Oh yeah. Now we get to choose the character. In this game, you choose one character at a time, and yada yada yada. So yeah, here's my order. I'm gonna start with Terra, then do Ventus, and then do Aqua. It's only fitting. We do it in that order.
Today you will be examined for the mark of mastery. Not one, but two of the Keyblades chosen stand here as candidates. This is neither a competition nor a battle for supremacy. Not a test of wills, but a test of heart. Both of you may prevail, or neither. But I am sure our guest, Master Xehanort, did not travel all this way to see our youngest prospects in years fall short of the mark. I trust you are ready.
Yes.
Then let the examination begin.
And there's a little bit of that dark voodoo hoodoo.
Take care of himself. He's been out there training just as hard as us.
Yeah. Stay sharp, Ben.
All right. So it has begun. It has begun. So we're going to be doing... Okay, wait. Did my headset die? Oh my god, my headset actually died! That's fine though. I can plug it in. Alrighty. Let me take care of my plate first and we'll begin.
I'm gonna also grab a drink real quick. Actually, you know what?
Alright. If I haven't had chocolate looking time, good. Like I said, we're starting with Terra first, then we're doing Ventus, and then we'll finally do Aqua. Makes sense. We do it in that order. Let me also check my stream length. 34 minutes.
That was unexpected. But one must keep a still heart even in the most trying of circumstances. It was an excellent test, one I chose to let unfold. Which brings us to your next trial. Now, Terra and Aqua, the two of you will face each other in combat. Remember, there are no winners, only truths.
I'm forgetting. His voice sounds so freaking familiar. Is revealed. I think I might have heard it in an anime. I'm not too sure. Oh my god! It's freaking Mark Hamill! I didn't even realize he was in Kingdom Hearts! God! I totally forgot I did not...
We have
again, it's been years since I've played.
Terra, Aqua, you both performed commendably. However, only Aqua has shown the mark of mastery. Terra,
You fail to keep the darkness within you sufficiently in check. But there is always next time. That is all. Aqua, as our newest Keyblade Master, you are entitled to certain knowledge. Please wait here for further instruction.
Hey.
Terra, I'm sorry.
The darkness, where did it come from?
We all know who. We all know where it came from.
What do you make of Ventus?
He ain't gonna cut it. Somebody's gotta break that loser in.
Not here, you won't. I have to keep up appearances.
I know that. He just needs a little incentive to leave home.
Sorry. But I need some time alone. There's darkness within me. So what does that matter? I know I'm strong enough to hold it back.
Yes. You are indeed strong. The darkness has nothing to fear.
Master Xehanort.
And yet, how frustrating that Ericus refutes its power. Why, you could train with him forever, and still, you'd never be a master in his eyes.
But why? Help me understand, Master Xehanort. What is it that I failed to learn?
You're fine as you are. Darkness cannot be destroyed. It can only be channeled.
Yes. Thank you, Master.
Yep. Don't know what that comment was. But I'll definitely say this.
What happened?
I don't know. Why isn't Ven here?
Very well, then. I will send my pupils to investigate. Yes, I understand. Farewell. That was my dear old friend Yen Sid. As you know, he is master no more. But he still keeps a close eye on the tides of light and darkness.
So yeah, at one point in his life, Yen Sid was a Keyblade Master.
The wielders of the Keyblade must walk. All the more reason then for concern. For he tells me the princesses of heart are in danger. Not only from the forces of darkness, which you may assume, but also from a new threat. One that feeds on negativity. Fledgling emotions that have taken monster form. Yen Sid calls them the Unversed. As wielders of the Keyblade, you are tasked with striking down any who would upset the balance of light and darkness. The Unversed are no exception. I tried to pass this news on to Master Xehanort, but my repeated attempts to reach him have failed. I doubt there is any connection in it. This all troubles me.
Master Xehanort is gone?
So here we are. I need you two to get this situation under control. Eliminate the Unversed, and find Master Xehanort. I have unlocked the lanes between. You may use these forbidden pathways to travel between this world and countless others. The darkness looms closer than usual within these spaces, but your armor will protect you. Last night, remember that order must be kept. You cannot tell anyone there are other worlds. Now go, and fulfill your duty.
Yes, Master.
Terra, consider this an opportunity. A second chance for you to change my mind.
What?
You must know. I care for you like my own son. If I could have my way, I would name you master in a second. But how can I, when you are so obsessed with power? Terra, you mustn't be afraid of losing. Fear leads to obsession with power. An obsession beckons the darkness. You must never forget.
Thank you, Master. I swear, I will not fail you again.
Oh, don't worry, we will be playing all three stories. For those who are curious to watch this on YouTube later, be like, Storm, aren't you gonna do every single story that is known to man? Well, yes, I'm gonna be doing all three stories, including the true ending, which the true ending involves Aqua, which I will be doing Aqua last. So, it is. Makes sense if I do the one that gave me brutality hell first, right? Like, do Terra's story first. So get ready to witness me suffer through pain and misery as I go through the lingering will. Forge the D-Link with Ventus. How D-Linking works. While D-Linking, you can use other characters' commands. D-Link gauge will drain as long as you remain linked. When the gauge runs out, your link will be broken. D-Linking fully restores your HP. Refill your gauge by collecting these D-Link prizes. D-Link prizes! Defeating enemies while D-Link may cause drop special emblems. Collect the emblems to power up the D-Link. Forge the D-Link with Aqua. So yeah, we're doing, unlock the command board for the Land of Departure. Okay, so, I already can tell you the first three worlds we start off with. We start off with Cinderella, Sleeping Beauty, and finally, Snow... Wait, so, these three worlds are the first starter worlds. So, with Terra, we start in a world that I'm going to regret playing. Oh my god, trying to deal with a freaking laptop is like going through a haystack. And soon I gotta finish up dishes, so that's gonna be a plus. We got 6 viewers. That's good. See, I like this layout a little bit better. I should have done this layout years ago. It's a Smart Alex paradise. That way, I could just have my phone up. I don't have to look at the screen. I can just sit back, relax, and just... play my game while I look at my phone and see who's on and whatnot. This makes it easier. Alright. It's only fitting we go through this world first. I'm gonna hate myself for it. It's gonna torment me because I know which world this belongs to. Not just Sleeping Beauty or anything like that, no. I know who also resides here. Penance, my worst enemy! Sleeping Beauty, yes, I'm aware of this, but...
Monsters.
Whoa!
The ones the Master mentioned.
Whoa, they changed the color of the Unversed in this game. Because I remember in the PSP game, they were blue. In this one, they're actually black or red. Maleficent? Yeah, Maleficent. I might have guessed.
Want some?
See, I'm gonna be using, See what I mean? Why I said I'm gonna start with the hardest character first? That's because I'm gonna start with the hardest character first. You see what I mean? You see what I mean? Oh, right. X is the dash, triangle's the land. Well, you already seen this scene. We might as well... Okay. I'm not gonna rely on the command inputs because I know this is gonna be brutal for me. Only when I need to. I should have started with Ventus. Holy crap! Well, I already forged my path now. Hey, Lanny. Welcome to the stream. Just eating your sub? I just had dinner not that long ago. I had chicken fillets. I just cooked them up. Work was hell.
Freeze! Thunder! Heal!
A coworker might get fired. Ouch. There we go! So, yep, the pain begins.
No, you don't.
And so begins my torture through misery and hell. And believe me, this was the character. The Unversed are tough creatures, yeah. And that, it doesn't also help the fact that I'm also playing on Proud. And the fact that I'm starting with the character that gave me utter hell back on PSP days. So yeah, of course I'm gonna have some issues. Oh yeah, they got the sticker thingies here, right? Yeah, these are sticker thingies. In the in Kingdom Hearts 2, they were called puzzle pieces. You're brave because I've never played this. If you ever want to get into the Kingdom Hearts series, I recommend playing. Okay. I'm thinking I keep this save. I'm thinking I'm gonna keep the one save for Ventus. Should I? Nah. You know what? No. You know what? No, screw it. That's how I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna use this Ventus save as literally my gateway to the other characters, okay? That's how I'm gonna do it. I did that with the PSP version. I'm gonna do exactly that. That way, I have 3 saves. I can just access the characters on the fly, and bam! So, we're going to make an entire new save data just for Terra. That way, I can just access the saves on the fly. Also, apologies if you didn't see gameplay on screen. Get ready to get used to this, because this isn't like the previous entries. Alright. Ooh, another treasure chest. No. I keep forgetting this isn't like Kingdom Hearts 1, 2, Rechain, all that crazy nonsense. Well, I don't count Rechain because it doesn't have the actual action RPG commands. Here we are, Enchanted Dominion. I hate this already. Speak of the devil, my arch nemesis of the Kingdom Hearts series! Yay!
That fool's Flora cast a spell to put everyone in this castle into a deep, deep slumber.
Who are you?
Why, I am Maleficent, as all who dwell in this kingdom would know.
The Dragon Witch!
Now you must reciprocate the introduction. Who are you?
I'm Terra. What do you know about those monsters?
Yeah.
The ones who attacked me.
Now,
it's already quite obvious that I already has a plan for all the characters. I'm gonna use that save data.
That's for sure. Anyway.
As my gateway to the other characters, because it'll detect the saves once I'm done.
That name is not familiar to me. Is he an outsider like yourself? Oh, but wait. I do remember someone leaving the castle.
Tell me, what was he doing there?
I couldn't say. I can only be certain he was not from this kingdom. If you're curious, go see the castle for yourself. There, the entrance is past the bridge.
Thanks.
Perhaps he did speak about imprisoning the light. The light could be so many things. Could he have meant Princess Aurora?
Aurora.
Oh, just you wait when I get to Ventus' story. It's gonna be one wild goose chase. Actually, now that I think about it, it's gonna be one wild goose chase with both Ventus and Aqua. Technically, because I think he's like the dragon version of, Maleficent as Aqua. I think. It's been years. Oh, I gotta add the potions to my command deck. Duh! Yeah, I think I already see how this works. Command points. I can't add anymore! Action commands. That stinks! Well, that stinks! How am I gonna heal? Well, that's right! Don't I have these, Wait, I can rename the... I forgot I can rename the finishers. I'm stupid. You should not give me this power. Okay, so how do I use items? Oh, meld com- Oh, it's kind of like the sentences. Okay. Items. Equip. Stock. Oh, these are the things. I can't really equip any new Keyblades yet because I don't have that. Prizes. Quick Blitz. Blah, blah, blah. Memory is now coming back to me. I am aware of this. Config. Wait! Type A? Is there a type L1 and R1? No, there's no type C where I can make the triangle button X. The X button triangle. Oh well! Oh well. There we go, Stun Edge is now level 2.
You're done.
Ow! Strength, level 2. We reached level 2. Alright, now we get to go over here. So, into the castle we go. Oh yeah, there's puzzle pieces. Not puzzle pieces. I'm so used to calling those crown icons puzzle pieces because it's... Yeah. this definitely shows you it's been... Shows you that I am not ready for this area. I can already imagine the horror that awaits. Okay, so I don't have any more room for a deck edit. Okay. Definitely say.
So long.
That this is going to be one hell of a doozy. With a lot, right? Makes total sense I do that? Again, I am so used to the triangle button being the thing that opens the chests. This is Aurora's room. Aurora...
This feels so familiar.
Her heart is filled with light. Not the slightest touch of darkness. Just the kind of
bonkers.
Heart I need.
Come here, you.
For what?
Imagine with me the most glorious of futures.
Seven fused
hearts, each overflowing.
Oh, you can go about that, huh?
When brought together,
help.
They grant the power to rule.
You goofy cat. You are a goofy cat.
What do you mean?
Why, that key.
What the? Is Randy home
the
early?
Blend, is it called?
If Randy's home early, then I'm gonna have to finish up the stream tonight. So give me a sec. Let me go check. It's not time yet.
Give me a sec, guys. I'll be back. Come here. You is your goofy kitty cat. Get over there on the tower. You silly cat. Alright.
That trinket is the only way to obtain the hearts.
No more games. Where is Master Xehanort?
Impudence will get you nowhere, child. If you wish to learn more, you must retrieve the heart of Aurora.
And why would I ever want to do that?
It's not a matter of why, but of will. In your heart, there is darkness just waiting to be awakened.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Perhaps not yet. But I have power over sleep. And I can awaken what's inside you. Then you will be free to be who you truly are.
Remember, the darkness lurks in every heart. Darkness is our foe. Would that we could be rid of it. You must destroy it. Push the darkness down. Give it no quarter in your heart.
Talk about possession. And thus we now know how she started with Aurora.
Here it is.
Her conquest to try to get the seven princesses apart.
To think that all he spoke of was and will be true.
How did I...
What did I do? What did you do?
You speak as if I pulled some invisible strings. No.
Because she did! Because she did!
I simply whispered to the darkness you already held inside.
How could I do this? Ben!
Yes. Now, you want to know where Xehanort went. Well, that I cannot answer. He disappeared into the darkness. But now I know the Keyblade is necessary to gather hearts. Join me. Collect 6 more hearts of pure light. Then we will rule all the worlds together!
You seem to be mixed up. I'm a peacekeeper, not a tyrant.
For a peacekeeper, you're off to an exceptionally poor start. Remember this. The darkness in your heart cannot be held back by force or strength. Now, my work here is done, as is yours. Wasn't there someone you needed to chase?
Wait! The Unburst. They're gonna bring down the castle. I have to do something.
Forged a D-Link with Maleficent. And there's the Boogle. Got ourselves a map. I'm so used to the triangle button! Ah! Alright! So yeah, I figured since I do this the right way, we use the Ventus save file as our gateway to the other stories. Right? It makes total sense, because I did that with the PSP and it totally worked. So yeah, the Terra save is where I'm gonna save at. When I load the save that I started with, that's how I'm gonna do it. Every time I meet a character. That's how it's gonna work. Alright. Well, first, we gotta see what the Moogle has to offer, right? And the good thing there's... these commands, right? I don't even have enough money for them. So, yeah. I'm not seeing anything else out here. Figured I'd look. Again! So used to the commands being only a pop-up. Attack recipe. Oh, that's right! Wait, don't I hand the Moogle that shit? No, actually, no. Okay. At that point... There we go. Thunder Chaser is her D-Link. I guess if I'm gonna use the D-Links, I might as well use them sparingly. Especially... Maleficent's D-Link. See, it would be nice if I had a potion option, right? That way I can heal. It's already obvious I'm gonna have to wait until I can get more from my deck. Reports, Terra. Sticker album! Well, I already know this is the... Arranged stickers are the ones... Oh yeah, don't... Alright. That's right. I put the sticker down so it increases the points. Okay, makes total sense. I get it. I know how it works. And I need... Oh god, talk about a long grind ahead of me. So there's four chests in Land of Departure that I totally missed, right? So we got three more chests that I missed in this area. At that point, we just now go back, right? We go back and deal with the Unversed. I'm curious. I want to try out Maleficent's D-Link. Well, looks like we got our first boss. But I don't have a Maleficent. And send bye! Oh, yeah. So, at this point, I might as well just. Make sure I grind. I'm gonna use Maleficent's D-Link for, That means I gotta get more! I know I said I was going to be using the,
You're done!
I had a recipe, I had a thing for her, but now I can't get it. Oh yeah, I have to kill Unversed just to get the thing I need. For me to use Maleficent's D-Link again, I need to... I need to fill up the gate anyways. I'm gonna just do the grinding trick for this area.
Take that! Fire! Want some?
figure I'd do this now. Oh yeah, we're gonna need to make sure we save the D-Links for each character. Like... So yeah. So, with the characters, unlike the previous games, if it's a cutscene that I've already seen, we skip it. But if it's a different cutscene each time, then I don't skip it. So, the plan of action is, when I do get to these cutscenes, I don't skip them. Not a single one, unless it's a cutscene I've already seen. So, therefore, when I do start a new story, any cutscene that I've already seen will skip. Why did I accidentally do that? No, back. Okay. Now that I have a part of Maleficent's doohickey. I'm gonna level up first. I mean, it's only fitting I level up first.
Fire! Want some? Take that! Fire!
There we go! We got Maleficent fully leveled up D-Link. Oh yeah, this is useful! When I'm using the power of my enemy at my advantage, that is going to be the perfect way to end all emotions on them. Now we just gotta do the same routine with Ventus and Aqua, and then we'll be all set to go. I forgot that I can use shot lock. I'm stupid. So here's my plan of action as I level up. Already need like freaking 29 experience to get to the next level and ruin everyone's emotions. Sorry if I keep popping in and out, Aurora, even though you're asleep.
You're done.
Oh, I forgot that, shot lock requires...
So long.
Alright. Might as well,
Yes, come on!
Kapow! Ventus got leveled up all the way. Talk about the power of D-Link bullshit. Dev said he's coming. Oh, don't worry. So yeah, I don't know how long I'll stream this for. Let's see here. An hour and 28? Yeah, once I beat this world, I'll definitely call it a stream, right? But first I'm gonna definitely make sure I save constantly as I do this, because I know I'm going to be making sure I get all the D-Links mastered. And I already have a plan of how I'm going to do each story. While, yes, I am going to be using a save to lock me in. The final story, however, once I get to that story, I will use that same save file for said story. So once I'm done with Terra's, I do Aqua's, and then I do you get the idea of the order. Alright, so we got ourselves a strategy, we got ourselves a plan of action. All right, now I can use Aqua's, right?
Freeze! Thunder! Heal! Freeze! Thunder! Want some?
Oh god, Aqua, your D-Link is draining fast. Can't say I'm a fucking genius when I do this. I just gotta keep grinding in this area. What? Right. Alright! Oh yeah, that's right! I can, buy some more potions, right? Because I know I'm gonna need a crap ton of potions when I'm done. 18 potions? I can suffice with that! But I don't have another command slot open for me. Unfortunately, I do not have another command slot open. Unfortunately. But I do know, however, by leveling up the other commands, it'll get me to the access to the other shit. So, I already finished the mindfuck that was recoded. I am now currently working on the story here for Birth by Sleep. There we go. Magic deflector.
Freeze. Fire. Thunder. Gather. Heal. So long.
All hate him! Ugh! God! So yeah, once we get grinded up to a good level that I can handle, we should be golden. But yeah, Maleficent is definitely useful in this game. For once. And I don't mean that as a character, I mean that as in a D-Link. Because her D-Link, her super, can literally summon dragon fire. Which is pretty useful in a pinch. Alright, now we got the D-Link leveled up again. Or filled up again, I should say. Now we just gotta swap over to Aqua again. Definitely.
Freeze! Fire! Thunder! Gather! Want some?
Damn, just wait for another.
Freeze! Fire! Thunder! Gather! So long!
I'm just waiting for another D-Link's prize. So I can level up her.
Heal. Freeze. Fire. Thunder. Want some?
And this is where I ignore the chat and only read what I am selective of reading.
Freeze! Fire! Thunder!
Randy's home now. There we go. So, we got ourselves a thing. I better save and see if Randy's home. Which Kingdom Hearts is this? This is Birth by Sleep. And yes, I'm doing the route that Dev did, but not because of the way he did it. Mainly because I'm doing it because I did Terra last when I played this on PSP a long time ago. And believe me, Terra's story gave me brutality. Even on normal, it gave me brutality. But now I'm doing this on Proud. So, prepare to witness me suffer a misery as I freaking try to complete all three stories on Proud. So, not home yet, so that means I can finish this up. I went into the wrong room like a dum-dum. So yeah, like I said, I'm playing all these stories on Proud, so get ready to witness me suffer through misery and pain as I complete Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep's three stories and the true ending as I suffer. I'm Proud. Be grateful I'm not doing this shit on Critical, otherwise I'd be chucking the controller through a wall. Alright. All the D-Links have everything leveled up thus far. I am now going to face the boss Heartless of this world. That is my Bane. And misery and suffering and pain. And my worst enemy being Sleeping Beauty's Maleficent. No.
I am finally fucking back, and no, it's not HK, it's KH, youth.
Oh yeah. I did something before I fought this guy again for the second time, because...
Yeah, you might want to level up to like... You might want to level up to like level 15 for that fucker. Fire! You're using fire, what the hell?
I'm using Maleficent's D-Link!
Dude, you know you just gave in to what Nope just said to do.
Nah, I really didn't, because I'm ignoring the chat feed because I'm doing things my way. And yeah, you're right. I do need to level up some more.
There's like 9 terms I blocked, by the way. Because of Paris.
Yeah, I'm aware of that. Also, I described Recoded as the mindfuck of Kingdom Hearts, because the moment I got into the card bullshit of the story, my brain exploded into pieces. And I'm like, my brain has turned into a blender.
Yeah, you should have played the game, dude. It was fucking hard as hell.
I'm glad I didn't, because... Yeah, I don't want to break a DS. Believe me. And those things being flimsy as hell? Yeah, I would want to go through that. And that is why I'm glad Dream Drop Distance got the 3D treatment, which I even stated after beating it. Which leads into Dream Drop Distance, but we're not going there yet. Because of that post-credit scene at the end. Also, apparently I didn't unlock the themes. I did everything in that game.
Yeah, I know. I saw that too, because...
Okay, so what level am I at? Level 6? Yeah, I already know that... This
yeah,
stream might
be at least level 10.
My stream might be a little bit shorter for this one because A, I just got done, not that long ago, I just got done with Recoded. And I know this game's going to be a lot longer. Also, I did a little strategy. I has an extra save, aka the save that I started out with when I went during the tutorial. I'm using that as my gateway to the other stories.
Yeah, you don't need that.
But when I do Aqua, I save over
okay.
it.
Okay, hold on, Paris. This is a prequel to Kingdom Hearts. This is 10 years before the original game, the first game of Kingdom Hearts. So we're gonna be playing as Terra, Aqua, and Mantis.
So yeah, I already has. A plan in my head, because I did this on the PSP ages and ages ago when I played back on easy and normal, but now I'm on a PS4 playing on Proud, so this is totally a different experience.
Yeah, and Lainey wants to play the games, and it's like, good luck.
I mean, if she wants a decent challenge but not to make it too easy, I say start her on normal.
Yeah, around normal. If you go in beginner mode, then who the fuck
yeah,
are you?
Yeah, beginner
fool?
Mode's way too easy.
Yourself or someone else?
Oh yeah, while I was grinding, I did get all the gifts, D-Link gifts, thus far, that I can access. So yeah, I already has a plan of strategy, because technically all you need is three saves. And once you get all three saves, the fourth save I'm going to use for the true ending. Because it makes sense.
Yeah.
This is the only time I ever do multiple saves, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. I'm doing multiple saves. I usually always do multiple saves with the Mars game.
That's why I have the Ventus save as like my gateway. Because...
Yeah. But when it comes to, like, Milk said something about being wise or serious, I wrote back.
I saw that Batman quote. Even though...
Because for Batman?
Even though I've never really watched much of the Christopher Nolan... Not Christian Bale. Was it Christian Bale? I don't remember.
Dark Knight?
Yeah, I never really got into those Batman films, unfortunately, which is really ironic.
Dude, that, like, Heath Ledger is like a fucking legend. Dude.
Now, nowadays, because I know about Heath Ledger and his passing and everything, and I'm like, you know what? I respect the fact that his Joker still has a legacy. Despite me not watching those films, I will respect the fact that he still has a legacy.
Dude, people actually look at his films as him being Joker, as like for future Jokers. I highly recommend looking at The Dark Knight, because that's probably by far the best Joker we ever had.
And, I mean, the Joker movie had a good Joker too. At least all
Phoenix
of them were
really
Jared Leto. I will definitely say that much.
That's not a Joker.
Yeah, Jared Leto is not a Joker.
They even tried
redeeming him in the just Zack Snyder cut of Justice League, which is pretty sad. By making him an utter nightmare. And I'm like, he already fucked up. Why bring Leto back? And that is another reason why. And that is the sign of Randy being home. Which means I'm probably going to have to grind off stream. Yeah, I hear you, girls! Let me at least finish this up, because I know this game's going to take me the longest. Alright, so we'll jump into dev side of things.
Well, I mean... Can I eat first? The fuck, man? You know what? I'll start my stream. Why not? But I'm gonna eat first.
Alright.
So, you guys get to enjoy Slurpy Slurps while I talk with Storm.
And then before after I do eating, that, I gotta make sure I let the girls out. So I'm coming. I'm just finishing up the stream now, because not that long ago, I just got done with the cutscene-based one. So, I already knew Birth by Sleep was going to be the longest game, so...
Yep, it's 45 hours.
Well, that's going to be the longest game.
Birth by Sleep, because it has three different character story arcs.
Every character has 15 hours to it, so 45 hours in total.
Yeah, pretty much what Dev said. So, that pretty much sums up the Birth by Sleep in a nutshell. But, yeah, this is part one of Birth by Sleep. We'll continue this section and finish it up in the next stream, and then go on to the next world. Which is going to be fun. I want to at least grind on this world off stream. That way I have a fighting chance against the Heartless. Unversed in this area, because the unversed boss in this area is a real pain. So, anyways, till then, here's the captain of the Hedge Fleet signing off. I'll see you in the next stream. Get ready for Dev's stream when he gets ready. Power something today? The lights flickered, but we didn't lose power. Like, it didn't, like, go black out or anything. Oh!
Alright, guys. Here we are. Welcome to my stream.
Alright, so I'm gonna raid Dev's stream.
Oh, for anyone that wants to be a little smart aleck, I'll be banning these terms on mine.
Alright, so I'm going to now end my stream. And we're going to raid Dev's stream. 2, 1, bam.